Hi there. All right, we're going to continue with our Venus persona charts. So we're going to take a look now at Will Smith. So Will Smith, another actor, because actors and actresses, of course, there are many times a leading lady, leading man. Their role is to be a projection vessel. They're supposed to be sort of the ideal that the public, that the masses will find attractive. And Will Smith is someone who, I think of him as being very charming and socially adept. So he's a Libra. And, you know, it's his sun is in Libra. He's also got a Venus in Libra. So his sun, 29 degrees of Libra in the 11th house. Yet another fourth house celebrity who's also known for being, he is an individual, him being a personality, because that's the sun, personality that is charming, Venus. Okay. And ruler for him, the ruler for his sun is going to be Venus, which is in Sagittarius in the first house. So remember, Beyonce had Venus conjunct Jupiter? It was her sun conjunct Jupiter and Venus on the ascendant. He has Venus 1 degree away from the ascendant in the first house. So it's just like Beyonce's chart. So there's some themes here. There's some patterns. It'll be really fun to dig up and think of celebrities or just individuals you know that you find attractive, first of all. Good looking, or even if they're not naturally good looking, they know how to, you meet someone who's just like, ooh, even if they're not the typical handsome or beautiful face or body, but their personality is really, really attractive and you like being in their presence, that's Venus. So someone who's really charming, that's Venus. Someone who's really annoying, that's Venus. They don't know how to maybe use their Venus in a way that's likable. They can be unlikable. It's also Venus, okay? So Will Smith, sun in the first, in the 11th, and Venus conjunct the ascendant. So we know he's also got a body that's beautiful. Mars in the 10th. That was like Audrey Hepburn. I don't know if her Mars was there, but her Venus, I think, or her sun was in the 10th, right? So Mars does represent the man. It's sexiness. It's more like Saturn is the grown man. The father, the guy that you'd want to marry. Mars is the man as a sex object or a sex symbol. Okay. So Will Smith kind of has, with Mars conjunct Pluto, that gives him a lot of charisma in the 10th house, Capricorn, right? Like, yeah, you're an attractive man. He's also got Moon in Scorpio in the 12th, like just a bunch of planets over in 10th, 11th, 12th. And then down in his 5th, which I found seems to be important because it has to do with the sun. It's your identity. Is Saturn there in Aries? That's the stoic, manly thing. It's the, I'm going to protect you from bad guys, you know? Yeah. So I almost feel like these charts, it's uncanny how much they really show you a deeper layer to a person's Venus. Now let's do someone here that's known for being highly polarizing, let's say. I should have pulled more of these. Maybe I'll do a little part three. I think I will. I'm going to do a little part three. This will be short, part two. I'll do a little part three with some people that are kind of, you love them or you hate them, right? Okay, so this is Courtney Love. Courtney Love was married to Kurt Cobain, for those of you youngsters who don't know Nirvana. Hopefully you know who Nirvana is. But she was married to Kurt Cobain, and a lot of people didn't like her. A lot of people felt like she was the one who caused his death, and there's just a lot of, she'd get into fights and cause drama and all that good stuff. So she's got her son in the 12th. So that's similar to Michelangelo, right? I have this. I guess, was it Brad Pitt that has the 12th too? So with her, if you pull her up though, look at her chart. Sun conjunct Mercury, exactly, 20 degrees of Gemini. Opposite the moon, moon's in Scorpio, it's a 22 of Scorpio, and it's in conjunct that Gemini sun. Her mouth, right? Like, sun conjunct, when you have sun conjunct Mercury in a chart, a lot of times, even in the birth chart, the person spends a lot of their energy talking about themselves or thinking about themselves from a very personal, subjective perspective, and have a hard time seeing things from the other person's point of view. And so sometimes, I mean, she was definitely known for being kind of a mouth, right? She'd get into fights with people, and, you know, she's got her moon in Scorpio in the 5th house. So moon in Scorpio in the 5th, when I see the Scorpio-Leo combo, you do tend to have a person who has a strong personality, and there can be an element, especially the moon, there's an obsessive, even revenge-based kind of nature. Or you might have a highly sexualized personality. You might use your sexuality to get what you want. And she's got Pluto, Uranus, Pluto, Mars down at the bottom of her chart on her IC. So that's like using her, not only her sexuality, but also her wounding, her childhood wounding to, she uses that socially. So perhaps, this big, huge grand cross you have in her chart, it's all immutable signs, the nodes of the moon are there too. It feels to me like someone who projects all of her stuff from her wounds onto other people and assumes that other people are going to maybe hurt her. Venus is right next to the ascendant and it's in Cancer. The other thing about her is she's had a lot of plastic surgery and done a lot of things to herself kind of to transform herself, I guess. Also you could tie that into her Pluto down in the fourth, and maybe even Sun in the 12th. If she's someone who is not comfortable with her identity, playing around with it and figuring out what is going to fit exactly. Sun in Gemini, trying different versions of herself. Feels like someone who's highly, just this combination, the Gemini to Scorpio, when it's the moon in Scorpio, emotionally not super stable, you know. And moon in the fifth is someone who can be really proud. And we have several celebrities that have this. It's you have to be, if you're going to get on stage and sing and play instruments in front of somebody, you got to be confident. You have to be bold, and there's a pride that comes with that. A lot of celebrities, you'll see strong, you know, Leo or fifth house markers. That's kind of necessary. what else about her? Let's do one more. Let's do Donald Trump here. And then I'm going to do a little part three, just find some people that are really kind of, you know, individuals that people love or hate. And Donald Trump definitely falls into that category. So his son, this is fun. He's a sixth house son. This is so perfect. So I would say, I'm not a psychologist, I'm not a therapist, but I would say Donald Trump probably falls into the category quite squarely of a narcissist, like the DSM, you know, what the DSM would state as a narcissist. I think he has all of the behaviors. And seeing his son in the sixth, and it's conjunct Saturn, makes me think this is someone who is really quite insecure with himself. You know, he's got all these planets as well, Pluto, Mercury, Venus, Mars, all over in the seventh and eighth houses. So his identity, his sense of his value has to do with how other people see him. And you can also think of the Mercury there in the seventh. You know, he talks about himself being this negotiator. He sees himself as being skilled in business, and that's Sun conjunct Saturn, you know, kind of, it is in Cancer though. And Saturn is like right on his descendant. So to me, this feels like he looks to other people for their validation, that he is a man, that he is in charge, which is interesting. And he is a bully to people, that he behaves like a bully, because Pluto in the seventh could indicate a fear, either I've got to control you or you're going to try and control me, you know. His moon here is in the second, so, which is kind of, his moon is over in that first quadrant with Ceres, which I think of as tied to Taurus, and moon in the second, looking for emotional security through having control over sort of your environment, and moon in Pisces is a moon that does feel more, it is a softer, weaker, for lack of a better word, more of a passive moon. So externally, and in his relationships with people, feeling like they're the ones that are defining who it is that he is, and that they can, that he's very sensitive, that he can get hurt really easily. And that's exactly how he is. If he doesn't have loyalty from someone, he like cuts them off and it bullies them. Mars in the eighth can be, I have to have control over this relationship with this other person, or else they're going to hurt me. They're going to attack me. It's like, I'm going to attack them first kind of a thing, or I feel like people are attacking me. So it's also has a lot to do with actively pursuing other people's resources to sort of better your position. So it's great for business. Okay, I'm going to stop here. I'm going to pull maybe a few more. Well, maybe I'm not going to do more Venus. I think you get the idea, but I am going to do Mars next. So